It's no wonder that so many of us take our bodies for granted. We take them with us everywhere we go. We've all been there when it comes to complaining about aches and pains. People have also been known to spend millions of dollars altering the appearance of their bodies. There are some, such as neurologist Randall Keown, who want to end human dependence on our bodies by creating computers into which our consciousnesses can be uploaded. This is overlooking what a beautiful, elegant machine the human body is, its many intricacies, its quirks, and its features. So let's break out the microscopes and give the wondrous body a little more of its due. Number 10. The prodigious data of a genome. In 2003, after 3 years of work, the International Human Genoming Sequencing Project declared that they had finished ordering the data that would allow them to write a human genome. It was noted that this was 2 years ahead of schedule. So why would it have been expected to take 5 years to write out the amount of data in a human genome? Well, a genome is a complete set of human DNA, which, as we all know, is basically the code that is ordered to make out a specific human and their traits. Those specific traits, such as hair color, height, and such, only comprise about 2% of DNA. The rest is more or less just sort of a standard human template. The code is usually broken down into patterns of the letters U, G, A, C, and T. A single genome of DNA will have 3.5 billion pairs of data in it to program a human being. This means that by the time they were done, they had finished the equivalent of translating 100 encyclopedias worth of information. Number 9. It's radioactive. Part of the reason human bodies are radioactive is inadvertence. The radioactive element, strontium-90, tends to accumulate in bones because the body tends to mistake it for calcium. Relatively large amounts of that were spread around the world due to pervasive nuclear weapons testing. But since it has a half-life of 29 years, the worst effects of that have passed. The more pressing concerns for many are those who absorbed the material from such nuclear disasters as Fukushima in 2011. The body also directly creates radiation through its nervous system. Every time you use your nerves to move an organ, think, or do anything really, that causes the fission of potassium-40 atoms, and that fission releases gamma radiation. On an average human being, roughly 10% of that will leave the body, or lower on a heavier person. This translates to a lifetime spent sleeping with another person being the equivalent of spending a few days in Denver or some other high-elevation city. This is to say that we're not radioactive enough to produce much energy. If all the nerves in your brain were harvested for electrical power, it would take roughly 2.85 days of charging time to fill up an iPhone. Number 8. Seeing with your ears. If you look someone in the eye, you're looking at one of the body's most counterintuitive contraptions. When you see something, first light passes through the lens of an eye, then it casts itself on the retinas in the back of the eyeball. In the process of passing through the convex material of the lens, the light is refracted onto the retinas upside down. So how does this image get right side up when it gets into the brain? This is where the ear comes in. It's the vestibular nerve in the ear that connects your eyes to the balance center and corrects your vision for the brain's benefit. This has some handy benefits merely having the retinas connected directly to the brain wouldn't provide. For example, it's the reason that you can tilt your head at a 90-degree angle without the world appearing tilted. This discovery has led to the belief that newborn babies with their nervous systems that are still coalescing actually do see the world upside down. So far, though, no babies have been able to confirm this. Number 7. It glows. So you've probably heard about people might be glowing when they're in a certain mood, but that is obviously not literal. In 2009, researchers Masaki Kobayashi, Daisuke Kikuchi, Hitoshi Okamura photographed the first known images of a human being glowing using the basic science of measuring biological photon reactions that has been known about since the 1960s. They placed 5 test subjects in a light-tight environment, brought out a charge-coupled device camera, and spent 7 hours photographing them. When the temperature was constant, it found that the amount of light and photons that the body emitted changed through the course of the day. That's not to say that you will be saving on light bulbs anytime soon. The amount of light is roughly 1/1000th of that which would be visible to the naked eye. Still, since the rate of photon emission was found to be linked to metabolism, Kobayashi suggested that after more studies, the technique could be refined to diagnose metabolic conditions. In the years since, some studies have been conducted with photon emissions to test the effectiveness of meditation. The results are reportedly promising, but inconclusive. Number 6. New body parts at different rates. Everyone knows from lessons about the dangers of excess alcohol back in their teen years that we only get one set of nerve cells that never replenish. But what about the other organs? How long does it take to replace them? Well, for one, the lining of your stomach only takes a few days to replace due to the corrosiveness of the stomach acid. Your skin cells are comparatively long-lived with an average of 3 weeks, but liver cells stick around for a robust 150 days. Even the longest lasting of the cells do get replaced, and those are bone cells. Those last long enough that your bones last an average of 10 years each. Each cycle, though, they tend to regrow a little thinner. This is why bones are more fragile among the elderly. As of 2020, the National Institute of Health estimates that roughly 50% of Americans over the age of 50 have chronically weak bones. Number 5. Growth hormones can cause shrinkage. In the early 20th century, experiments in injecting growing males with testosterone and females with estrogen began. The idea with the females was that they would normalize their menstrual cycles, and for males, it was used for those who were not growing satisfactorily tall. In the long run, the results would show that the effort was a misfire. The estrogen injections increased breast cancer rates for women in their 60s, and for the males, the testosterone could backfire in a more immediate way. Their pituitary glands shut down because the body was already full of testosterone, so there was no growth. By far the most famous recipient of this misguided treatment was Rainbow Connection and A Star Is Born songwriter Paul Williams. Since his father was over 6 feet tall, his thinking was that Paul, at only 4'6" in the fifth grade, meant that there was a problem, and they started the therapy. Williams said that it stopped the growth of his bones and sent him into puberty at the age of 10. Number 4. Why it needs metals. It's standard practice to include the heavy metal content on a nutritional information label, but why do we need copper, zinc, or iron? Well, we need copper to control heart rate and produce all sorts of cellular tissue, from bones to heart cells. Zinc is used for cell division and dissolving carbohydrates for heat and other forms of energy. Iron is also used in metabolism, but with the addition of helping transfer oxygen to cells. The amounts of metal in the body vary significantly, and in some instances can be surprisingly substantial. An average adult human only has roughly 50 to 80 milligrams of copper in them, barely over 2% of an ounce. By contrast, it's often said that the average adult human has enough iron in them to make a nail 3 inches long. Let's hope for your sake that this is the only way that you'll get one of those in you. Number 3. Slowly cooling over the decades. Of all the entries in this video, this one likely provides the single best piece of news. In 1851, the standard temperature for a healthy adult male body was set at 98.6 Fahrenheit. Since then, studies such as the one performed in 2019 by Dr. Julie Parsonet of Stanford University of 677,000 measurements found that the average man's temperature had dropped down to 97.9 Fahrenheit. And it hadn't been a rapid drop-off. The average reduction has been about 0.05 degrees per decade. Women came in at about 97.3 Fahrenheit. According to Parsonet, the reason behind this isn't related to a lack of activity on the part of most people. It's because with the adoption of healthier lifestyle habits and improvements in antibiotics, the number of people whose immune systems are constantly fighting colds and flus while remaining functional has declined. Not to mention that the fact that more and more people are living in homes with reliable temperature control means that people's bodies no longer require inflammation to remain active. Number 2. Calorie count. Now, this admittedly is a fairly grisly entry on this list. In April 2017, historian James Cole of the University of Brighton was researching cannibalistic practices in ancient tribes to see if they were performed purely for ritualistic purposes or for survival. To this end, he decided to determine the fat and caloric content of human bodies to see if they would yield a worthwhile amount of sustenance compared to available prey. He came to a conclusion that an average adult male human body weighing 145 pounds contains roughly 125,000 calories. Since the generally accepted amount of calories a person needs in a day is about 2,000, that means a human body would feed another human for slightly over a month, and a family of four for slightly over a week. A red deer from the time would yield roughly 160,000 calories for less risk, which left Cole inclined to conclude that humans were impractical as a food source, and thus the cannibalism was more likely for religious or militaristic purposes. Cole went into thorough detail in the analysis of a body's calorie value. For example, 1 pound of heart provided 650 calories, the liver has 2,569, the lungs 1,596 combined, skin offers about 10,280, bones 25,330. The delicacy of zombies, the brain, provides 2,700 calories. Hopefully, no one watching this video is ever going to put that information to use. Number 1. Own drugs. In a few ways, everybody's kind of a mobile drug lab. For example, there's dimethyltryptamine, which is a hallucinogenic Schedule 1 drug, often extracted from mushrooms. It also naturally occurs in human cerebrospinal fluid and is related to dreams. It's speculated that near-death experiences are related to it. Then there's the opiate pain reliever morphine, which in 2010, experiments indicated, inconclusively, that the brain creates out of another chemical. More firmly established in the late 1980s was that the body produces its own cannabinoids, specifically CB1 and CB2. Beyond the intoxicating effects, the National Academy of Sciences reported in 2006 that CB2 is used by the body to regulate bone growth. Since then, there have been findings that these cannabinoids are used for regulating a number of other physiological functions, which is why, in some cases, it's better to rely on the body's own cannabinoids rather than ingesting some more. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below and do not forget to subscribe. Brand new videos just like this every day of the week. For more from me, why not check out another channel I do called Biographics, biographies of notable people from history and the present day. I'm linking to that below. And thank you for watching.